Rise and Shine on Australia's Vision Christian Radio.
Well,
happy birthday to you. You're 102.
Not quite.
Just joking.
Not quite. 50 off. 50 off from that one. 52 today.
Oh, happy 52. Birthday. Yeah, it's been so fun. You know, the best bit about you having a birthday now is my birthday is when we're always off.
When's your birthday?
And so it'll never be reciprocated. It'll be fine.
When's your birthday?
In January. So we're set. There will never be a show on my birthday.
Late, early January.
Early-ish.
You're keeping
early
it,
enough.
Keeping it under wraps there. Yeah, we're never here on January.
Fantastic. So every year I can get more and more embarrassing and there will be no problem for
no
me.
No reciprocation.
No, it's perfect.
I've got to get Murray on the line here and see what we can work out here.
Did you have a nice morning, though?
It's been lovely. Lovely to hear. You'll hear some wonderful phone calls.
Yeah.
I think your plan to embarrass me with my ladies in my life.
Oh, too sweet. We should have got the boys on the line.
Yeah,
next
year
it's the boys every time.
The boys
time.
Are a boy, yeah.
Kids are the ones that you need to talk to get the goss.
No. Maybe my sister, maybe a sibling, my brother and my sister, they might have something for me there. But no, lovely, you get to hear my lovely wife, get to hear my lovely mum and some other lovely callers as well. Plus, the exciting conclusion of For King and Country.
We thought we'd never get there, but we've finally given away all the tickets, I think, apart from one.
Yeah, there's one ticket, one double pass in Adelaide left. There's a couple of names that might go to it. We're trying to work out what we're going to do, but thank you to everybody who's been involved and, sung for the tickets to For King and Country. You get to hear more of that on today. But I'm going to go celebrate my birthday. With I don't know what is going to happen upstairs.
Oh, I hope that they are popping things and there's a mess.
Are you saying you're never at work on your birthday? You do usually holidays.
Yeah, usually on holidays.
So having birthday at work with work colleagues and stuff, it's always a bit weird.
Is it?
It's always a bit weird.
Say that out loud.
I'm allowed. Is this recording? Is this microphone? Microphone's on. Quick, gotta get out of here. All right. I'm not learning. I'm not getting any smarter for my birthday here. We'll see what happens. I'll report it tomorrow and let you know. Enjoy the show.
Bye-bye.
It's the daily podcast of your favourite Aussie breakfast show, Rise and Shine. Rise
and
Shine.
And look, DJ, it was a bit of a special weekend for you. The lead up to the birthday, pretty special. Did you do anything fun?
Oh, well, thank you for asking. Yeah, the brothers Payne, my three boys, and one of the boys' girlfriend, shout out to the wonderful Monica, they all chipped in together and got Benita and I basically a weekend away. And so we were able to get away in the city there, stay in a lovely hotel on the Friday night and on the Saturday night. It was just a lovely time of just chilling out,
nice.
You know, not doing much. We went for a little walk around, but really it was really just a very relaxing time. And it included, on both mornings we were there, buffet breakfast.
Oh, okay. So what do you go for at the buffet?
The question is, what don't we go for? The question we literally, I'm not recommending this to anybody, but we got so full on Saturday morning that we did not eat anything for the rest of the day.
Right. Just one big meal.
One meal.
There you go.
Done by 10, and then you are done for the rest of the day. I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing, but it was a pretty amazing selection. You know, as soon as I have a chef there who's doing omelets for people.
Oh. I mean, that's fantastic.
I'm like, let's go. This is great. You're right in there. But it was an amazing selection. But I've got on the back of that, I've got a question for you.
Oh,
I've got a question.
Yes.
Maybe we can chime in after the next song, but you can let me know. And I need you to be honest.
Wow.
Does anything come, if when you're at a buffet breakfast and there's fresh fruit?
Sure.
It's cupcakes.
Yes.
There's
bacon and eggs.
There's pastries.
Yes.
There's fruit.
Yes.
There's some like wrapped sort of items as well.
Mm.
Does any of that maybe
have a go?
Come with you? After
really?
Yeah, that's my
Do you
question.
Take
is
a gift basket?
Yes. Is it all? Again,
what are the rules?
I'm watching, and I'm not trying to justify anything here. I won't throw myself into the deep end yet. But I'm watching waiters taking away people coming in and piling up plates and plates of fruit and everything like that. They eat two things. And the rest of it just goes, there's a lot of waste with those all-you-can-eat buffet places.
Okay.
So my question is, you know,
should we take a doggy bag from a buffet?
Is a doggy bag for an all-you-can-eat buffet okay? Oh. Is that the thing to do? Where do we draw the line with that? Okay, have a think about it. We'll come back on the other side.
Well, maybe someone who works at a buffet might be able to tell us.
Yeah. If you've got any opinions about it, give us a call. 1-800-316-316. I'll come clean and tell you honestly what I did.
Oh, I am curious now.
Yeah, exactly. In just a moment.
You can't get in trouble on your birthday.
No, it's impossible.
I've heard of all-day breakfast on the menu, but here's a brekkie show available 24/7. Thanks for streaming the Rise and Shine Daily Podcast.
The birthday boy, aww, DJ.
Woohoo! Woo. Well, listen, a birthday boy means that I think you suggested this. I can't get in trouble on my birthday.
No, I'm guessing. Well,
new rules.
We're going to test
that. Okay, we'll test that right now. We can test that right now. My wife is the most holy, straighty 180.
She seems like quite a rule abiding person. Glad she's there in the house of pain.
Well, we definitely need her. Don't worry with a bunch of us. So when I go, you know what? I'm going to grab a banana for the road,
okay,
or I'm going to grab an apple.
Yes.
Or I might have grabbed a couple of muffins, or, you know, maybe
your
I wrap.
Your pockets are full. Yeah, are you one of those people, you've got the trench coat with all of the different pockets?
Shh, don't. You're going to get me in big trouble. Okay. I might do a serviette and a couple of pieces of banana bread in there like that for later on. You know, I do that, but Nita won't, like, she'll just look at me and, like, you know, she, if I go, oh, there's a, you know, you get the little packets, the alfoil packets of butter.
Oh, right.
And I got a couple on plate. Now, I've seen.
Yes.
They don't go back in on the plate.
Well, you can't really.
You can't.
Germs.
The waiters are, they're going straight in.
Sure.
I might chuck it. She won't even put one of them in her pocket, you know, because they don't want to steal anything and, you know,
sure.
And I'm like, just, it's going to the bin. Who cares? Let's go. So I might do that. So there's a house divided there in those ones there.
Dear.
But I do have to say that she did eat a piece of banana bread later on.
Don't tell me how
you got it, but I will have it because I'm hungry later on. But I'd love to hear from you if you think that's a bad thing to do, or that's okay. That's okay. It's a buffet breakfast. What are you going to do? It's time for the Vision National News headlines. Am I the only one?
Well.
I hope not.
Love the Rise and Shine podcast? Tell a friend today.
And it's a big happy birthday day today for a DJ Payne.
Yes, and you're being very mysterious over there with the phone. Something's going on over there.
That's right. I'm going to make a quick call here.
Okay.
To someone who you might like quite a lot.
All right.
And see if they've got any messages for you for your birthday. Here we go. Okay. Make a call.
All right. Okay.
Here we go. And I think we've got it.
Good morning.
Good morning, Benita. It's Fel. How you doing?
I am well. How are you, Fel?
Yeah, good. Now, I wanted to give you a buzz because I've got your birthday boy here.
And you certainly do.
Hello, my love.
Hello. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday. Thank you. I don't know where this is going, but anyway, Fel wanted to give you a call.
See what Fel has to say.
I just felt that it was important that you got to say good morning and happy birthday.
Oh, that's sweet.
Obviously, I'm not trying to embarrass DJ or anything like that.
No, never.
No. Not on the radio.
I do that myself all the time. That's okay.
Actually, you could tell us. He was just telling us about taking some food from the buffet over the weekend.
Yes.
How do you feel about that?
Me. Yeah. What can I say? He was getting the bang for the buck for the experience.
Well done.
No wastage there.
No. And Benita will not let me, like, I'm trying to get her to, you know, hey, you got room in that, you know, pocket, a handbag. Why don't you put, no, Benita's going to walk 5 steps ahead of me. I'm not with this guy grabbing a banana over here.
Very embarrassing.
Very embarrassing. That's true.
I do my best.
Benita, you've had, would it be safe to say 23 birthdays with DJ at least?
Oh, at least.
At least. Is there one of those, maybe more?
Almost 33, yeah. Nearly. On my age.
Is there any of those that stand out in your mind as interesting birthdays?
Ooh, well, I'm just going to have to say this last one has been fabulous. Thanks to our boys. It's so nice to be at a place where they're so generous of heart to give us some quality time, which I think between the two of us is one of our favourite love languages. So, it was just lovely to reconnect and just enjoy the city and explore somewhere different now that we've moved up here to Queensland again.
Beautiful. Mm. Oh, that's very nice. So there's nothing embarrassing about DJ at all that you can share.
No, not really. I think he did it well. He embarrasses himself.
That's the joy of living with an honest and overly honest person is there's nothing embarrassing.
Nothing
there.
Hidden.
Yeah.
I think actually partly coming up here when he was, you know, a new kid on the block at the station wearing his new pants, I think that all went viral with you guys. Splitting your pants at work, I think, is probably out there for embarrassment.
No, I didn't know about that, actually. Can you tell us that story, Benita?
So, essentially...
I think the video's still out there on the social media.
Footage, yeah. He's walking along in his pants, and then later on, one of the staff members called him over and said, "TJ, you might just want to go and check in the bathroom your pants." And turned around, and there's a big split right down the back of his pants.
So. Like, not just a split; it was like from the top of the belt all the way down to my inner seam, like halfway down my thigh, gaping hole there.
Baggy pants,
so very baggy pants. No idea. No one's told me anything. I'm walking around half the morning anyway. Oh, boy.
Making an impression there.
Yeah, making a big impression there.
How long had you been at the station at that point?
That was the first week. That was my first week here at the station. So people knew exactly what they were getting in more ways than one right now. Yeah. And there's a side note. I haven't had a chance to say this. There's a side note on that embarrassing story. First time I got to catch up with Martin Isles. He goes, "Oh, you're the pants guy."
Oh, no.
Because he follows our social media.
So there you go.
I was like, yeah, great. Thanks, Martin. I'll be catching you later. All right, no worries, buddy.
Well, I'm glad we could keep the story fresh because I didn't know that. So now it lives on. Yeah. So well done, Benita. Thank you.
No worries.
Yeah. Oh, well, hopefully you get a chance. We'll send him home at some point today and you can spoil him tonight as well.
Look forward to it. Happy birthday, DJ.
Oh, thank you, my beloved.
Oh, so beautiful.
Oh, shucks. Oh, the lovely bee.
She's so sweet.
Well.
I mean, she did just throw you under the bus with your pants. Well, apart from that.
Yeah, we'll have to repost that video, I think.
I do want to know.
A year later, the pants are still being talked about.
Oh, that'll be years and years into the future. But okay. Happy birthday.
Oh, well, thank you very much. And you're with Fel and DJ and the lovely Benita on the line this morning on Rise and Shine.
Special's birthday. I'm enjoying this.
Oh, you are enjoying it a little bit too much over there, being very sneaky with the phones over there.
That's right. I've got someone else on the line.
Oh, no.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Is that Mrs. Payne?
It is.
It's
Happy birthday,
Darren. Hello. Thank you. Thank you, my darling mother. Let me introduce you to my co-host, Fel.
Hi.
Hi, Fel.
Oh, look, thank you so much. For letting us interrupt your morning.
That's all right.
We've been celebrating Darren this morning. Or DJ as we know him.
Yes.
And we thought we'd better give a call to the person responsible for the creation of DJ.
Yes. Well, I did that, yes.
Well done. And I'm imagining, yes. Mrs. Payne, that he must have been a bit of a chatterbox growing up, was he?
I can't remember.
Or maybe for the best.
He loved to draw. He loved to read. I couldn't say that he was a chatterbox. Maybe when he was with other children, but no, he was a delightful child.
Aww. Look, he was
a lovely big brother to his sister when she came along. Yep. Very loving. Oh. And, he was my gift, yes.
Very sweet.
Yeah, he loved to draw. I know that from a very early age and had a very good perspective of where things go. Like he would start drawing from the foot. Not a head.
Really?
And the body, he would start at the foot, then draw the leg and... Yeah, it was amazing. I'd just stand there amazed.
Yes. That does sound unusual.
So that tells you something about his brain.
It's got the upside down view of the world. That's just
very sweet.
In his teenage years, he got into music very early. Yeah. Yes.
So you would have had a noisy household.
It was a challenge for my dear old mum and my boombox down in the bedroom. Mum's like, turn it down.
But I wasn't old then.
No.
That's right. You're
sorry,
young mum.
Dear young mum. Dear young
right,
mum.
That's right.
Oh, well, you, mum, you're a great mum. Yes. You did a wonderful job. You gave me, you know, my passion for reading. It's all from you. My passion for, you know, the Word of God, that you instilled that in me as a young, for a very young age. I remember you getting all the correspondent Sunday school material.
Yes.
You know, in all of our moving and, you know, doing that Sunday school material with you as a young, I was little, yes. You know, around the kitchen table. You inspired me, Mum.
Oh, good. Oh, did something right.
Definitely.
I think you did a few things right. Yeah, right. Exactly. Yeah. I love you heaps, and I'll pop in and see you later on today.
All right, darling. That'll be lovely.
All right. Bye.
Bye.
Mama. That's the wonderful Suzanne Agnes Eveline Payne.
What a great name.
Yeah, yeah. Nee Galvin. Her maiden name was Galvin. Now you know where we got the middle boy's name from. Galvin, yeah.
Oh, Mrs. Payne. Well, there we go.
Yeah.
She's amazing. She's got some beautiful women in your life.
Very, very important women in my life. Yeah. God's blessed me with, you know, with quite a few. So there we go. Hey, look, enough about your dear old mate DJ here.
The Rise and Shine podcast.
And we are giving away for King and Country tickets, the biggest tour that's going to happen this year. I mean, these tickets are the hottest tickets. Well, it's, you know, May, June, it's in the middle of the year. 5 years it's been between, you know, they sold out their last tour that when they were here 5 years ago. They were planning on coming back straight away. Little thing called COVID happened and they've had to put it off till now. Now they've got a film coming out. They've got all this stuff happening. Absolutely bigger and bigger than you can imagine. And it's all happening. And we've got double passes to give away. We've given away most of them. We've got a handful left.
That's right. So we still have some double passes for Perth. There's a couple there.
Yes.
A couple, maybe two or three in Adelaide.
Mm-hmm.
And then one left in Canberra.
Okay.
So if you're in those locations, it's not too late. You can still get your double pass.
All right.
But
so
we are making you work a little bit for it.
We're making you sing. So I just want to make sure that you've got this. So on the 25th of May is the concert in Canberra. We've got one double pass left for Canberra. Pay attention. You've got one pass there. Adelaide. Adelaide's wide open. I think we've got maybe three double passes for the 23rd of May in Adelaide and two double passes left for Perth on the 20th of May. I know it's early in the morning in Perth, but we need you over in WA. We need you to give us a call.
Or you might know someone in Perth and you could win the tickets for them.
Look, that is a great idea. How good is that? Now, all you need to do is take the lyrics to a For King and Country song, and we're asking you to countrify, otherwise known as put the country into For King of Country.
That's right.
And we've got some country music instrumentals.
Maybe we should play a little bit.
I like it.
You can choose the instrumental that you think works best with the lyrics
okay.
of the song.
I think this is the most easiest one. The first one is the easiest one. I'm calling it the hoedown. Goes a little bit of something like this. I think you can put the lyrics to this, to any For King of Country song, to this pretty easily. So, you know, you grab your For King and Country lyrics and you sing them over the top of this. Exactly.
Yep, okay,
the classic,
that's,
you know,
very good.
It's what a lot of people think of when they think of country music. They go to that hoedown sound.
Okay.
Now, this one's a little bit more country rock. So you might pick out a particular For King and Country song and sing over the top to this one. A bit more classic, like we're talking like that 80s, 90s country rock sound. Goes like this.
Classic.
If that's the vibe you want to do, you can pull your For King and Country lyrics onto the top of that one. And the last one we're giving you is, I call it the country driving. Imagine you're in the pickup truck, the windows are down, you're going through the farm. Sounds a little bit something like this. Got some pedestal in it. Pedestal, you know what I'm talking about.
Here we go.
Goes a bit of something. Maybe you can
hay
do
in
it.
The mouth.
Yeah. You get the hay seed out. Maybe you got a lyric that can go to this one. So there are your three options.
And it's that easy. You could sort of almost talk.
You can almost talk about that one. That
would be an option
if
you weren't prepared.
If you want these double passes. So again, I'm going to let you know, double pass, we've got at least one for Perth, we've got some for Adelaide, and we've got one for Canberra. If you're in any of those places, or you know someone who is, all you need to do is call now, get your For King and Country lyrics up, and be prepared to sing them over the top of one of those tracks. It's that easy.
Been having a lot of fun with.
Oh, this has been great. Australia really turned it up here for King and Country double passes. We've got a handful left in a couple of locations. We're looking at you, Perth, Adelaide, Canberra. Perth, Adelaide, you've got to get in it to win it. All you need to do is sing a for King and Country song over the top of some country music. 1-800-316-316.
Okay, guess what? We've got someone on the line here, DJ. We've got Bethany. How are you doing?
Good, thank you. Awesome. How are you?
Yeah, good, thank you.
Now, are you ringing up for King and Country tickets?
Yeah.
Now, you're in Goondiwindi, aren't you, Bethany?
Yeah, we've got friends in Canberra.
Oh.
Do you want to win some for your friends in Canberra?
Yeah.
That's very kind.
Bethany, how old are you?
9.
Oh, let's go. All right, well, listen, have you got a for King and Country song picked out?
Burn the Ships.
Okay, that's seems to be a popular one.
Famous one.
Yeah, Burn the Ships. A lot of people. Okay, now what style of music did you want to go for? Did you want to go for that country hoedown, or you want to go for something a bit more rocking or a little bit more softer?
Country.
Yep, yep. All right. I'll do, you know what? I'm going to do the bit more of the mellow country driving.
I think driving. the driving sounds good.
Now, is Mum or Dad going to help you with this one?
No.
Well done, Bethany. You don't need any help. You've got this sorted.
All right. Are you ready to sing it out loud?
Yes.
All right. Woo. Here she is coming to the stage, the lovely 9-year-old Bethany. Give a big round of applause with her version of Burn the Ships. Bethany, take it away.
How did we get here? We're cast away on a lonely shore. I can see it in your eyes, dear. It's hard to take for a moment more. We've got to burn the ships.
Is that it?
Woo!
Done?
Yeah.
I was getting into it. I wanted you to keep on going, Bethany. That was great.
Well done, hon. That was amazing.
Thank you.
Oh, now your friends will get to go to the concert. You're so lovely.
Who are you going to give these tickets to?
Sharon and Mick.
Oh, well, Sharon and Mick are very blessed to have you as a friend.
Yeah, yeah. Big shout out to Sharon and Mick there. Well done, Bethany. Now, listen, we're going to get you to grab your dear mum, Mel, there, and we're going to get some contact details for you in just a moment. But congratulations. You've got the last double pass to Canberra.
Thank you.
Woohoo!
Oh, well done, Bethany. That was so good. Well, listen, that means I'm looking at a little spreadsheet here.
Well, is it a spreadsheet?
Well, I've got a blue card.
Yes, I have an actual spreadsheet.
That means, by my calculations, Phil, double check on this one.
Yeah.
We've got two more double passes for Perth.
Yep.
And probably three for Adelaide.
I think so.
All right, so Perth and Adelaide, if you're up for it, you got to give us a call right now to sing for King and Country, Countrified.
Lots of laughs with lots of heart. The Rise and Shine podcast.
Well, I'm excited because it's for King and Country double passes. Woo! Giving them out. All you need to do is Countrify a for King Country song. And we've got tickets left in Perth and Adelaide. We're looking at you to give us a call and make them country, put the country back into for King and Country. 1-800-316-316.
We've got Rodney from Adelaide on the line. And how you doing?
I'm doing very well, thanks. Oh, look, I just became grandfather again.
Oh,
at 11:58 last night. So Zachariah Eli Hall was brought into the world. Hallelujah.
Oh. Amen. On the 17th, well, he missed it by a couple of minutes to be my birthday buddy today.
I know. He just missed out.
Well, he's a March baby, right. But that's okay. That's okay. That's good. Hey, listen, now, you're Rodney, you're in Adelaide. You playing for some tickets in Adelaide?
No, not today. I mean, look, I've been a real winner. You guys have blessed my family so much with winning things that I'd like to bless my dear sister, Elise Anderson in Perth, with tickets to King and Country.
Oh, that's beautiful.
My goodness. Yeah, it is such a sweet, sweet thing to do. Well, you know what you've got to do for this lovely sister? You've got to be able to grab some for King and Country lyrics and sing them over a country song. Have you got a particular for King and Country song you love?
Yeah, we'll go with a fairly recent one. What are we waiting for?
Oh, favourite. Yes.
All right.
Let me just say, listen, I'm prepared to pay for my own ticket to Adelaide.
Well, bless you heaps. We love that, Rodney. But what particular type of music do you want? Do you want the hoedown? Do you want the rock? Do you want
Absolutely. Absolutely. We've got to go for the full-on hoedown.
Yes. Baby. The full country.
All right.
Love
it. Here we go. Here we go. This is our man Rodney in Adelaide playing for his sister in Perth. Going to pull up the music here. Rodney, take it away. We're ready when you are.
What are we waiting for? Waiting for, waiting for. What are we waiting for? It can't be what we can't see. Can't speak when we can't breathe. Can't dance if we don't move our feet. Whoa, 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 it's a blur trying to keep pace. Days are running like it's a race. Can't move if we're in our own way.
Oh, Rodney.
Wow.
Rodney, I think I got in my own way.
No, you were great.
That was absolutely so fantastic. The emotions were running high. That was excellent, buddy. Excellent. One of my favourite hoedown ones yet.
Yeah,
well, I think for King and Country might be in contact, and they might have to get you featuring on their next country song.
Woohoo!
Hey, Rodney, congratulations. You're going to be able to send that beloved sister over in Perth to for King and Country.
Hey, man, that'd be wonderful. Just one last thing to say.
Yeah.
Yeehaw!
Well done. Well done. Absolutely great, Rodney. There we go. That's how you do it. It's as simple as that.
We get you to countrify for King and Country song. Mm. We've only got a few passes left.
Oh, we're getting down.
We have got Kelly on the line from Adelaide. G'day, Kelly.
Hello there. Nice to chat with you both.
Oh, wonderful.
Thank
for you to
get,
yeah, give us a call. And now double pass for Adelaide to see for King and Country on the 23rd of May. What for King and Country song are you going to countrify?
I'm going to attempt to countrify God Only Knows.
Oh, yes, do it.
I think this is a really good one to pick. I think this is very countrifiable. All right. So we've picked the good old driving, a bit slower. You got the pedal steel in there. So are you ready to go to this spotlight on the stage?
I'm ready as I'll ever be.
Yes, that's the attitude.
I'll count you in here at the start of it. Everyone, welcome Kelly from Adelaide.
Woo!
Doing a country version of God Only Knows. Here she is. Take it away, Kelly.
I hope you can come in, Phil. God only knows. God only knows what you've been through. God only knows what they say about you. God only knows how it's killing you. But there's a kind of love that God only knows.
Oh, that sounded good.
Whoa.
That sounded great.
Awesome.
That was excellent,
Are you
Kelly.
Serious? Kelly, you're a star. That was amazing.
That was so good. I was worried
very
there at the
impressive.
Start. We thought we'd lots you at the start there.
But I didn't know when to start.
Oh, sorry.
That's the hardest
sorry.
Part. We needed the start.
Yeah,
you did amazing.
That was fantastic.
Very, very good.
Well, listen, congratulations, Kelly.
Yes.
Because of that amazing rendition, country music rendition of God Only Knows, you're going on the 23rd of May. You'll be in Adelaide to see for King of Country.
Woohoo! Oh, you guys are so gracious. Oh, thank you.
So
that
good.
Was wonderful. That
well
was wonderful,
done.
Kelly. Hey, stay right there. We're going to grab your details, but that's how you do it. That's how you play Countryfy for King and Country. We've got.
Do we think we have time for another one?
Oh, I think we'll squeeze one more One more in.
It's the all new Rise and Shine Daily Podcast.
Countryfy, King and Country.
Oh, I'm excited because we've only got a couple left, and all the way from Iluka in Western Australia, we've got Michael on the line this morning. Good morning, Michael.
Good morning, guys. How you doing?
Oh, listen, we're all the better for talking to you. So we're looking at tickets, the last double pass to Perth we've got for the 20th of May. If you were to succeed, who are you taking with you?
Yes, sir. Well, this would be a great excuse for a date night with my wife.
Oh, you get the tickets. So you don't have to do anything. That's just beautiful.
Actually, on May 11th, yes. We would have been married 18 years and known each other 20.
Oh, love. Man, the stakes is high now, mate. The stakes is high. All right, what for King of Country song are we going for?
Oh, I think we'll do the famous God Only Knows.
Okay, yeah, great. Well, I've got the perfect music here. We've picked out the country rocket here for you. So here he is, Michael Inaluka, playing for love this morning. God Only Knows. Welcome him to the stage. Woo! I'll count you in. Ready? Ready, Michael? Ready? Take it. 3, 2, 1. Take it away.
Sing with me now. God only knows what you've been through. God only knows what they say about you.
Oh, yeah.
God only knows how you're killing you. But there's a kind of love that God only knows.
Woo!
I think you could do the whole song like that, Michael. That was fantastic. Brilliant,
You represented Perth brilliantly.
Yeah.
That's as country as I know.
Well, very, very, very good. Well done.
Well, congratulations. Happy anniversary for May because you're going to be heading over there to... Boot scooting over to the Viking Country Show. Well done. Congratulations.
Well, and listen, I called this morning because I heard you said you needed someone from Perth. Yeah. And my first thought that crossed my mind is, I don't want you to think there's not people out there listening because I have you on the car at least once a day and love what you guys are doing.
Oh, bless you heaps, mate. That's bless you heaps. Well, we appreciate you and we're going to get you to hold right there.
Wait a minute. Are you telling me Vision's breakfast show is now available around the clock and on demand? Incredible. The Rise and Shine podcast. Rise and Shine.
This is the time of the show where we hand over the reins and let you choose what's going to take us into the day. And on the phone, we have Kiwi Steve.
Kia ora, good morning, blessings all. Happy birthday, brother DJ.
Oh, you are too sweet.
Yes, all good there, brother. You had a good weekend?
I had a great weekend. How was your weekend? Because from memory, you've got a very special person in your life who shares, I'm a birthday buddy with.
Yes, my little granddaughter's little Tilly's 5, so she's off. Well, she started school a wee while ago, so yes, and into the swing of things. So your little Tilly today's 5, so
and a birthday party for her over the weekend.
Yeah, it was yesterday. Beautiful hot day here in Melbourne, so it was good. We had a water slide and a bouncy castle, and now I've come back to work for a holiday.
Oh, happy birthday,
too
Tilly.
Sweet. Oh, well, gee, that's gorgeous.
I wonder, Kiwi Steve, do you have a song to take us out with for the birthday boy, perhaps?
Oh, yeah, let's go back just a couple of years.
Yeah.
I think it's Aim High by Charlie Peacock.
Oh, you have got a great memory. Aim a Little Higher, Charlie Peacock.
Is that the one?
Yeah, that's the one, yeah.
We're only in our 20s, so we just got to work our way up to
the DJ. Oh, you're sweet. I love the fact that you remember how much I love Charlie Peacock, one of my favourite artists here. It's too good, buddy. All right, well, this is a great song to hear for my birthday, Aim a Little Higher. Kiwi Steve, you keep safe in the truck and make sure you give Tilly an extra cuddle from us, especially, her birthday buddy over here.
I will indeed. Blessings all. Thanks, guys.
Just about sundown on the levee road near the old fishing hole. Teaching me to shoot straight and true was your only goal. You threw a can up in the air and smiled. I pulled the trail, missed by my. You said, aim a little higher than you can miss. Bless the cat. Shotgun kiss me. Aim a little, aim a little, aim a little, aim a little higher. Aim a little, aim a little, aim a little higher.
Charlie Peacock, Aim a Little Higher, a curtain call from our Kiwi Steve to our DJ Payne for his birthday.
Very, very special. Love the song. Love that lyrics. If you want to relive that one, it's off the album Everything That's On My Mind, Charlie Peacock, 1994. Great album. Beautiful song, Aim a Little Higher. Fel and DJ here for your Rise and Shine. Usually we're getting out of here around about now, but I can see someone on the line, Fel.
That's right. We've got Marguerite from Brizzy on the line. Marguerite, how are you?
I'm really wonderful and even better for hearing you guys.
So sweet. Now, how can we help you this morning?
Well, I've picked up my ukulele, haven't played it for a very, very long time, but I felt the challenge today to pick it up, polish it off, and do a little rendition of Happy Birthday for our...
You didn't have to. I'm very excited. I love the ukulele.
Okay, well, I had to record it because, you know, me with my tech, I had to get that happening.
Yeah.
So you ready?
Yep, ready.
Happy birthday.
You'll have to send me the recording of that. That was amazing. That was beautiful.
I was trying to not have my husky voice. I'm not a smoker, but I've a husky voice, and I don't like it because I sound like a smoker.
No, you sound great. It was beautiful.
Well, you're beautiful. You both are so awesome. And thank you for getting me back to my uke, because music makes us so much happier.
Yeah.
And I need happy at the moment. Yeah.
Well, get into it. I would love to hear more ukulele from you, Marguerite, anytime.
Well, I'm going to go back to Bums, which is Brisbane Ukulele Musical Edition.
What a great name.
I know. And you know what the Sunshine Coast guys are called?
No.
Scums.
ukulele players must be an interesting bunch.
They are an interesting bunch. Marguerite, that is a beautiful way. I can't think of a better way to finish off the show today than with that rendition of Happy Birthday.
Amazing. And you know what? I got to see the YouTube clip of Warren's rap for me, and that just made me cry because he's so good.
Yeah.
And he's so talented. And to see you guys and your faces, I was like, I had pictures and you didn't look anything like it.
Sorry to disappoint. Sorry to disappoint, Marguerite.
Honestly, but I'm like, you know how you get a mental picture of what 100%, people look like?
100%. Definitely. Don't worry. We get it all the time working in radio. But I tell you what, we do the same thing to people who ring us up. We've got ideas of what you guys all look like. And then when we get to meet you, we're like, we didn't imagine you looking like that at all.
Well, I really hope that one day I can meet you guys.
We'd love that. We'd love that. Hey, bless you heaps, Marguerite. It's been an absolute wonder to hear your beautiful song this morning, and it's an absolute blessing.
Oh, look, you guys bless me every time I get the chance to hear you, so right back at you.
too beautiful. Marguerite, that is a great way to say goodbye. So we'll have a wonderful day today. We'll see you first thing tomorrow morning. Bye-bye.
Thanks for taking time to listen to this audio on demand from Vision Christian Media. To find out more about us, go to vision.org.au.